Now, let's talk about dealing with mental health as it relates to the ongoing coronavirus pandemic. Life as what we know it has changed dramatically, from wearing face masks in public, incorporating social distancing into our daily habits, and dealing with the stresses of job loss, deaths of loved ones, and dealing with the everyday hope of wanting things to go back to normal. The economic downturn and staggering job losses due to the global pandemic has resulted in loss of health insurance, financial stability, housing, food, and the safety net of saving and resources. The ongoing pandemic has shifted the way we live our day-to-day lives and taken a toll on our overall mental health, especially those who are at the forefront of their professions, like preachers, doctors, and even professors. I talked with Dr. Leonard Moore, professor at the University of Texas at Austin, and he explained how his family is trying to find their new norm in the times of COVID-19. Dr. Leonard Moore and his wife met in their teen years. Church events brought the couple together, but it was transparency and love that would bond them.
We started talking at the convention and we had a long conversation, and I just happened to tell him all about my life, all the drama, all the things I had been through, all the things I had overcome. And so I told him that as like a friend, you know, not as thinking that we were going to hook up or date ever. And I probably told him more than I would tell somebody who I dated, but it actually ended up being a good thing, because when we did start dating, he kind of knew what he was getting into. He knew some of my background issues and the baggage that I brought to the relationship.
The couple has been married for 20 years and has 3 kids. When it comes to the Black family, they say the saying is true: representation matters.
We raised them up on a lot of Black history, you know what I mean? You know, had them watching Roots, had them watching Emmett Till videos, even at a young age. And so for us, man, it's very, very important that they know who they are.
In the Black community, mental health is an issue, one that seems to be taboo. And now, in the middle of a pandemic, it's at the forefront of conversations.
The fact that I spend every waking hour, though, with my family, with my husband and my children, that's been an adjustment. But I would say it's worked out to be good. Like, a lot of families, it doesn't work out for their good. You know, a lot of families have, they said the divorce rate right now is at an all-time high because you're spending so much more time with your spouse. But it's helped us to grow and to realize that, you know, this is who we have, you know. I would say as far as my children, I do have one daughter who I feel like it's affected her mentally in a not so good of a way. And of course that weighs on us as parents, because you're trying to figure out what the best route of it is. Do we just pray for her like Black people do, or do we get her counseling? Mm-hmm. Do we put her on medication, you know? And I'm torn with that, because growing up, maybe my parents should have done more for me as far as helping me get counseling and things like that. But because they didn't, all my mother did was stay on her knees and pray for me. That's my go-to. But I know that we have other things available to help us with that. And so just trying to apply those things and help get her the help that she needs has been challenging for me.
The pandemic has also shifted how we interact with people, how educational classes are conducted, and gave us a new norm, forcing us to be diverse.
It's okay if you don't get anything done during this period. You know, you read these articles like, you know, the pandemic, you got a lot of time, you can get a lot done, you got to come out of this pandemic better than you went in it. But some people just can't function, and that's okay. You know, it is okay to be unproductive during this period of time. I would say that's number one. And number two, me and my wife were talking about this yesterday. However you cope, now we're talking about healthy coping mechanisms, but however you cope, like my daughter, she likes going out to eat with her friends. She's a social butterfly. She's not at school. She plays volleyball, but you know, her girl's not really on the team. She's like, she's one of the only Black girls. So for her way of coping, and we've talked about this, you know, she likes to go to Starbucks every day and then 3 or 4 days a week, go get a meal with her friends. And it hit me that I had to be okay with that, because that's how, you know what I mean? That is how she's coping, and that's how she recreates her community when she can't be at school.
Normalizing the discussion of mental health in the Black community can potentially